All right, we gotta find Brother Nevad, Brother Antonius. Siskin. Yodik. Lucas.
What troubles you? I need to make a confession.
I'm no priest, but tell me what you've done. It's probably nothing to worry about.
I'm here in the monastery looking for a thief. He had a hand in burning down the Neuhof stud.
You don't say. And who are you to take such an interest?
That's not important.
Why are you telling me this anyway? What do you want from me?
Perhaps you could help me find him?
The missing thief. If I knew anything, I'd tell you. But I suppose it must be one of the novices. I've only recently heard about the Neuhof incident. All the other brethren have been here much longer than that.
I know. Aside from me, there are only four novices. But still, I don't know which one he could be.
Three? Please, leave me out of it. And you're right that it could be any one of them. No one knows anything about Lucas. Siskin might be a lot of things, but a monk isn't one of them. And Yodok is a slimy worm. It wouldn't surprise me if he was behind that massacre. Actually, the more I think about it, the less I like that Yodok. He's a treacherous rat who'd do anything to get in someone's good books. The thought of Yodok at Neuhof sends chills up my spine.
I don't think it was him. But please, don't tell a soul what we've been talking about.
Don't fret, my friend. Your secrets are locked inside my lips.
What, sleeping? There we go, I can see. 3 a.m., start of the day. 4 a.m., prayer. Yeah. I could see, that'd be great. They have a torch. Legit, I'm just gonna just read books. Oh, just study the book. Well, again, my daily schedule is literally to sleep. Go to bed. Yep. Fuck it. I'll sleep for longer. I guess fucking hungry, man. I need food. I need food. Dude, you just like to yell at me, man. Shut up.
In a rush to pray?
God be with you.
Is this like literally like I'm literally praying. The fuck? Couldn't just manually skip this? Or couldn't just like click a button and tell me to skip this? And they actually like manually do it? Eat with the others.
Why such haste? Slow down, brother.
Nah.
Slow down, brother. In a rush to pray?
Yeah. Yeah, I am.
Watch your step, brother.
Meow.
Why such haste?
So much the more of the punishment for sin, because avoid evil works. Therefore, since the spirit of silence is so important, permission to speak should rarely be granted even to perfect disciples, even though
what?
You will not escape sin. And in another place, death and life are in the power of the tongue. For speaking and teaching belong to the master. The disciple's part is to be silent, to listen. And for that reason, if anything has to be asked of the superior, it should be asked with all the humility and submission inspired by reverence. But as for coarse jests and idle words or words that move to lie,
actual hell, man.
We condemn everywhere with a perpetual bow. And for such conversation, we do not permit a disciple to open his mouth.
What troubles you?
The rule of Saint Benedict. Readings on pain and idleness is the enemy of the soul. Therefore, the brethren.
Everyone just pulls out a spoon out of nowhere.
Hours in sacred reading. To that end, we think that the times for each may be prescribed as follows. From Easter until the calends of October. When they come out from prime morning, let them labor at whatever
is dirty ass robes they got.
About the fourth hour. And from the fourth hour until about the sixth, let them apply themselves to reading.
Literally already they are dirty.
After the sixth,
how the fuck did I manage to do this? I don't know.
Let him read to himself in such a way as not to disturb anyone else.
How long do I do this for?
Let them be said rather early, at the middle of the eighth hour, and let them again do what work has to be done until Vespers. Weak or sickly brethren,
I have no idea how long I do this for.
Keep them from idleness, and at the same time not to overburden them or drive them away with excessive toil. Their weakness must be taken into consideration. The rule of Saint Benedict. Readings on the
shit.
Let us do what the prophet says.
Not mean to do that.
I will guard my ways, that I may not sin with my tongue. I have set a guard to my mouth. I was mute and was humble and kept silence even from good things. Here the prophet shows that if the spirit of silence sought to lead us at times to refrain from speech, so much the more.
I guess I wait again? I don't know. What the hell?
Finishing what they built.
Why is this such like creepy ass music?
Praise
like intense.
Be to Christ, brother.
I'm here to work.
Excellent.
I've been waiting for you. There's the alchemist's laboratory. You'll find ingredients in the chests next to it. Today's task, 2 cockerel potions. Once you finish them, you'll find me somewhere nearby. Don't forget to let me know when you're done so I can check them.
I have no idea how to do alchemy. Take it all. Help. Alchemy is a useful skill that transforms herbs and other ingredients, potions, and remedies in the order to prove knowledge of alchemy recipe. Okay. Okay, so I can read by this. Cockerel. Mint and valerian. You will need spirits, a handful of valerian, and two of mint. Grind the mint. Boil the mint for 1 turn. Add the valerian and boil for 2 more turns. Distill. All right, prepare. Wait, grind them in. I'm so sorry. Grind them in, boil them in for 1 turn, add the valerian. Good to go. Mortar. Well, I would need the mortar and pestle. Oh, mint. Bellows is not what I want. It just increases the fire. Spirits. Mint. Mortar. Need 2 mint. Pestle. Do I have to grind the valerian at all or no? Okay, nope. Flip it for 1 turn. Valerian. This is the cauldron. Heat that up. Just flip the boom. Keep the fire going. Gotta flip one more time. Flip one more time. Boom. We'll bellows it up one more. There you go, I should be done. No idea if I'm actually done. Hold it until the fire dies out. I may have put too much heat in the fire. Did I not steal it? I'd be mad. Oh, then D still. The fuck does that mean? God damn it. Did it though. Spirits. We'll need spirits and a handful of Valyrian. Wait, does it say? I can't tell if this is one or seven Valyrian. I can't tell. This is gonna bug me. Alright, well. Fuck it. Go at it again, I guess. The spirits go away. One here. I wonder if you have to grind it separately, and that's why it didn't work. I wonder if that's why. I mean, I guess it might make sense, but it'd be just annoying if it didn't. Going. Add the Valyrian. Flip. Keep going. Flip. I should be able to distill it now. Dude, how does one fucking do this shit? File. Aha. Got it. Hey, I did it. Holy shit.
Praise be to our Lord Jesus.
Talk to me, brother.
I did it.
I finished my work.
Show me what you've made. Spectacular, Gregor. You've found your talent. Soon enough, you'll be teaching the other novices.
Yeah, okay. So I found this page.
Ah, Gregor.
I found this piece of parchment. It looks like it's been ripped out of a book.
Who'd tear up a book like that? Brother Librarian might know.
How? Where's this guy? I'm gonna find Antonius. I think he's it. I think he's the one.
Praise be to Christ.
I'd like to ask. Are there any...
Yes. From the moment talk began about electing a new abbot, it's been like a hornet's nest.
Tell me something about it.
Abbot Peter is old. When he dies, they'll have to select a new abbot from amongst the brethren. The candidates are John and Nevlas.
Well, that's all.
I guess we'll go to noon. Go to prayer. Ugh, fuck. Gotta do a whole day. Forest is done. Gotta do a whole day of living a life so I can save. I don't have any save your schnapps. Well, I wonder. Go back. What do you need? Prepare wine, 2 handfuls of. What do you need? Boil the needles for 2 turns. Grind the belladonna. So boil 2 needles for 2 turns. Alright. I don't know if I have that kind of stuff though. Do not have it at all. It makes me sad.
rush to pray?
No, praise but I need to get done.
I'm here to work. Good. This is most likely the first time you've ever done this in your life. But it's easier than you think. Just a bit of practice and learning Latin. Here's the original, and here are the blank parchments on which you'll copy what you read in the original. Is that clear? Then you may begin, and try not to make a mess of it.
Oh shit, what do you think that is? Looks like that. Oh shit, what? I think we're starting right underneath the first red line. Sure. Looks like that one. Being a monk fucking sucks. In the 1403, in the year 1403, it's not fun. Yeah, he's gonna say, you need some work because you suck. It's all wrong.
You call that a copy? You've completely ruined the parchment with your scribbling.
Yep. Latin sucks, bro. Still a cobweb. What is my life looking like? He's a lost. I just kill the dude and be done. This is tedious. This is the most tedious thing I've ever had to do in this game. Past two now. I think I have stuff to do. No wonder the church is corrupt here. I'm bored. be praying now. I don't know what I'm supposed to do, man. I really don't.
Pay more attention, brother.
Pay more attention, brother.
Everyone's running into me. Pay more attention, brother. Pay more attention.
What's your step? In a rush to pray.
There.
Pay more attention, brother.
Slow down. Why such haste?
Why such? What's your step, brother?
Wait through this. We're almost done. Eat with the others. Talk with you real quick.
What troubles you?
There's something I should tell you. Something you won't be happy to hear. I'm here to find someone and, well, to do away with him. But listen, it's not murder. Not when it's a man like him. He's one of the brigands who burned down Neuhof. He doesn't deserve to live.
What's he doing here? And who are you?
They call him Pius because he used to be a priest. When he found out a lot of people were after him, he hid away here. And as you can see, escaped suspicion. They sent me here to find him and bring him to justice. He's one of the novices.
So we have one outlaw and one assassin in our midst. This place is a lot more exciting than I expected. Do you know who it is?
Well, that's just it. It could be Antonius?
Antonius? He's a fine fellow. No, it can't be him. Although, you never know what's hiding beneath a man's skin.
See how hard it is? It could be anyone, and at the same time, nobody in particular. I won't tell you more, and I'd like you to keep silent about this too.
You're talking about killing in the monastery. I really should report it.
Would you do that? I have a feeling you wouldn't.
You're right. I'll keep it to myself. I've got problems enough of my own without involving myself in yours.
Yeah.
And besides, I mean to be gone from here within a year, so why should I care what happens with the monastery?
Thank you, Siskin. I appreciate it.
You're neglecting your daily schedule by not eating.
Idleness, and at the same time not to overburden them or drive them away with excessive toil. Their weakness must be taken into consideration by the abbot. The rule of Saint Benedict, readings on humility. The first degree of humility is obedience without delay. This is the virtue of those who hold nothing dearer to them than Christ.
Hmm.
Who, because of the holy service they have professed, and the fear of hell, and the glory of life everlasting, as soon as anything has been ordered by the superior, receive it as a divine command, and cannot...
Just wait another hour, fuck. That's all this game is. Wait. It's what, 7 o'clock? Time to go to bed now? You've been poisoned. Oh shit! What? Well, I'm dead.
You've got a strong constitution. Anyone else would have certainly died.
What happened?
Let me tell you a little story. Once upon a time, there was a young boy. He was lost and miserable. He had no future. He was tempted by his friends into doing some foolish things, but he wasn't truly bad, because when it came down to it, he ran away rather than keep doing foolish deeds. His former friends didn't take kindly to that, though, and wanted to punish him. So they sent a hunting dog to find him and rip his throat. The boy wasn't stupid, though. And he knew that the hound was coming. He poisoned some food, and when the hound showed up, he gave it to him. He didn't expect the beast to live, but it did. And all of a sudden, the boy was sorry for what he tried to do. So he offered to make a bargain with the hound.
I think I understand you. But the beast would need to know what deal he's being offered.
He said beast, not hound.
You know, we're both pawns in someone else's game. They have plans for us. But we don't have to let them use us. We can just forget all about it and go our own way. I was a bandit, and I was at Nyhoth. I've robbed and stolen. But I swear to God, I've never in my life slain innocent people. What I saw at Nyhoth made me realize my life was worth shit. But I still had a chance to change for the better. Here in the monastery, I've had plenty of time to think things over. But then you showed up and fucked it all up.
So the evildoer changes his ways and finds God. What exactly are you proposing?
Both of us can leave this place. You can go back to your people, and I can go somewhere where I can live out my life in peace, and no one will try to kill me. If we work together, we can both get what we want.
You're right. But the people who sent me will find out if I don't kill you.
They won't if we're clever about it. No one has to die. Before we make a run,
yeah, okay.
We'll make it look like someone's killed me. Loads of blood, a tattered scrap of my habit, and footprints leading towards the river. No one will bother looking for my body there. There we'll split up. You go for your bounty, and I'll get as far away from here as I can.
Good. Let's do it your way.
Good. I'm glad that despite our initial discord, we could reach an agreement. Here, take something to calm your stomach. Now we'll need the keys to the monastery and some blood to make the tracks.
And where am I supposed to get my hands on blood in a monastery?
You'll find a parchment in the kitchen with a list of ingredients on it. All the things they're ordering. Add blood for making soup to the list. And when it's delivered the next day, take it before anyone notices it's even come.
What do I need the keys to the monastery for?
How else will we get out? This place is practically a prison.
Getting the keys won't be easy.
I know, but Brother Salarius is a reformed thief. I'll bet he still has a few lockpicks lying about. If you know how to use them, they'll be worth finding. Or there's the hard way. Steal the keys from the prior. He He carries them with him at all times.
They both sound hard to me. But needs must. All right, that's everything I need to...
Excellent. Come and see me once you have everything. And try to be as fast as you can. And Gregor, thank you.
That would sound more sincere if you hadn't just tried to kill me.
That's why I'm thanking you. For being so reasonable despite what I did. For what it's worth, I'm glad the poison didn't kill you. And we can both come through this alive if we work together.
Cap, do you just try to kill me? There. Healing up. Okay, so, I mean... I think, eat with the others. Yeah, that's not me. I need to, quit full screen. I'm about to sneeze.
Peace be with you, brother.
I was looking for the reformed thief. I don't want to do that. I kind of want to steal the keys. Make things more intense.
In a rush to pray.
But I don't know where this guy would be at.
This looks like the dregs after a night's drinking. Who could be coming here? Yeah, I'm looking for somebody.
Pay more attention. Why such haste?
Looking for a certain somebody. You guys want to help? Yo.
Aha, Gregor. Talk to me.
I'm looking for something a little, unorthodox.
And what would...
I'm looking for lockpicks.
Lock picks? And what would you like those for?
I'd like to practice opening locks, just for the fun of it.
Just for fun? Pull the other one, brother. It's got bells on. Anyway, you're barking up the wrong tree. I can't help you.
You lying sack of shit.
In a rush to pray?
Why such haste?
Try to open that fucking door.
Pay more attention. Why such haste? What's your step, brother?
Tell me where to get some blood, bro. Ew. Okay, and this is where I'll be ending the day. So at least we have a mission.
To pray?
Oh, shut up. Tired of hearing that. That was a fucking prior.
I'm Gregor and I'm...
I know. I saw you in the church, Duke.
What does that mean?
I make sure everyone observes the rule.
And when it's not the way...
Then we're author...
I'd like to ask... Who's in charge of...
Abbot Peter is the administrator of the monastery. You won't see him. He's always traveling, and on top of that, he's old and infirm. Perhaps the good Lord will bless him with many more years of life.
And what happens when the old abbot dies?
Then we elect a new one.
Are there any candidates?
Yes, there are. Brothers John and Nedlas. Cursed elections. On one side are brothers who'd like to see John as abbot. On the other, those who support Nedlas. And they seem to be capable of fighting about it forever.
Tell me about John.
John is the Circator and the oldest brother here. It would be only natural if he took the crozier from Peter. He has experience, merit, and composure. He...
Okay... Shit, there we go.